June 1975, 2 months after the surrender and defeat of South Vietnam, South Vietnamese soldiers were imprisoned. During their time in imprisonment, captured Southern Vietnamese soldiers were forced to hard labor, cutting down forests, destroying homes, and working in the fields. However, a few months after the Southern Vietnamese soldiers were arrested, the Viet Cong told families to move to the forest if they want to see their loved ones soon. My mother's family followed their request and moved to the forest, while my father stayed behind in Saigon.
Là nếu mà muốn cho ông nội về nhà sớm á, tự do đó, khỏi tù đó, thì bà nội phải lên trên rừng gọi là kinh tế mới đó, ở trên đó thì nó mới cho ông nội ra. Thì nhưng mà bà nội không có tin, tại bà nội lúc đầu là bắt ông nội đi vô dòng tù mà nó nói ông nội chỉ đi có 1-2 ngày đi học thôi về, nhưng mà lúc đó nó giữ lâu hơn nữa, cho nên bà nội không có tin đó, bà nội không cho đi. Bà nội nói lên rừng rồi lấy gì sống, cho nên bà nội giữ gia đình ở lại Sài Gòn.
Lúc mà đó mẹ 7 tuổi, mẹ phụ bà ngoại giữ Út với là giữ cậu Sáu, rồi bán quán phụ bà ngoại, rửa chén, rồi hép bà ngoại.
My mother, since the age of 8, stayed in the forest for 8 years. She had little income and took care of the family. On the other hand, my father and his siblings sold pastries along the streets for money. He, at the time, was only 7. With little profit from the sales, they moved to their grandparents. 1979. After 4 years, my father and his family heard news of my grandfather. Around March 2nd, 1981, my grandfathers were released from jail. My mother continued to stay in the forest with my grandfather for 2 more years. Due to their low income, they didn't have money to move back to Saigon. Finally, at age 18, my mother moved back to Saigon in 1986. February 4th, 1993. My father flew to America and landed in Arlington, Texas. A year later, September 26, 1994, my mother landed in Louisiana to register herself and went to Texas a month later. 2 years later, 1996, October, my parents met in America. Soon, about a year later, 1997, August 31st, my parents married each other. Four years later, on January 22nd, 2001, they had a son named Andy Huynh. About 2 more years later, March 2nd, 2003, my parents had me. Currently, my mother works in an alteration store, while my father works in finance. My family and I still uphold our family and cultural traditions to this day, such as food, clothing, music, and more. One family tradition that we do is traveling around the country with each other. In our household, we primarily speak Vietnamese. However, we sometimes speak English too. Overall, I learned that my parents went through many hardships and traumatic events just to get me here where I am today.